Hey guys, this is Mike Tarallo with Qlik, and it's time for you to learn what's new in our latest Qlik Data Analytics release, September 2020. This release has a lot of great new features, some with focus on our new enhanced augmented intelligence capabilities with Insight Advisor leading the way as your intelligent assistant. This video will just be a quick summary. Look for the longer feature demonstration in the description where this video is posted. So to get started, we'll cover our search-based analysis improvements. While in a QlikSense app, you can immediately get answers to business questions using natural language with search-based analysis. Our Insight Advisor will auto-generate the most relevant visualizations and analyses for the user based on natural language processing. With each release, we continue to add more advanced capabilities to address new use cases. Insight Advisor can now generate several new chart types that take advantage of advanced analytical functions, such as k-means cluster and correlation. These new charts include cluster chart, correlation chart, and control chart. Search-based visual analysis generation is also now available on mobile devices when using the QlikSense browser interface, allowing the creation and search of analytics on small form factors as opposed to traditional authoring. I'm pleased to introduce you to a new conversational analytics experience native to QlikSense, available in the QlikSense Hub on our SaaS environments, Insight Advisor Chat. Insight Advisor Chat provides multi-language, natural language processing that understands the user's intent and delivers insight using natural language generation for a deeper understanding of your question. Insights include auto-generated charts, narratives, observations, and more. Users can dive directly into search-based visual analysis for further exploration, and because it works across QlikSense apps, it allows people to find the right insights even if they don't know where to look. For an in-depth demonstration of this feature, please see the longer feature demonstration video. September 2020 introduces a new concept called business logic. Our new business logic layer allows you to create business rules and metadata to customize and guide the behavior of Insight Advisor when generating insights and interacting conversationally with users. It includes the ability to logically group fields, classify data, specify default behaviors, define preferred relationships, and more. Users can create calendar periods to define how measures should be filtered, aggregated, and compared based on preferred timeframes. And they can customize natural language processing, including defining vocabulary rules and synonyms for more natural interaction. For an in-depth demonstration of this feature, please see the longer feature demonstration video. We also have added some visualization improvements to this release. We have added the ability to include and style reference lines for your dimensional values in bar and line charts, allowing you to mark dimensional elements such as start and end dates of important events. And we now have a new animator control, giving users the ability to animate changing data over time by auto-selecting values in any dimension and playing them in a loop. You can also control the visibility of the hover icons that appear over charts, and there are some additional formatting and styling improvements. Please review the Qlik Help site and see the What's New document for this release to learn more. With the September 2020 release, we are introducing advanced analytics calculations onboard the Qlik Associative Engine. The first functions available support k-means clustering, allowing data points to be grouped into clusters based on similarity. This is a highly useful function for customer segmentation, fraud detection, and many other use cases. Going forward, we plan to introduce additional advanced calculations. The Qlik Data Analytics release for September 2020 also has some other new features and improvements which I won't cover in this brief video. If you want to learn about these and more, be sure to check out our other video materials and the What's New page on the Qlik Help site. Well, that's it for this video. If you want a deeper dive on these highlights and more with each release, be sure to sign up and subscribe for our Qlik Insider webinar series, with the next one scheduled in November. If you want to be notified when more videos such as this are posted and are viewing from YouTube, be sure to subscribe and click the bell icon. We want to hear from you, so tell me in the comments what you think, and don't forget to check out these other great resources to learn more about Qlik's data analytics and data integration products. And please remember to join the conversation with myself and others in the Qlik community. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you on the next video. Take care.